Welcome to Canva, CSU Extension's new online design platform. Today we're going to be quickly going over how to resize and also how to save your marketing materials once you've created them in Canva. We're looking at a simple recycling poster that was a template within Canva. I've changed some of the colors to be CSU branding colors. Some others I haven't changed yet. We can just quickly go through and do that. So I'm selecting the images I want to change. I click this button up here that says color. It opens up the sidebar color palette. And then I click underneath CSU brand colors, the color that I'm looking for. As I've mentioned in some other videos, not every single thing that you do in Canva has to only use this palette. But following the CSU brand guidelines, we know that overall we need to have a strong presence of green in our marketing. So making sure that green is one of the primary colors here. I might change recycling at the top to the green, and I have the green here. That opens things up that if I wanted to use another color as an option, I could. But this looks really nice, and this is all CSU official colors, including the grays and the greens and this Aggie orange and our, of course, CSU gold. So I'm happy with this design, and now what? So, like I said, we're going to talk about the resize feature in Canva, which is so fantastic. So next to File menu up here on the left, we have the title of our project. Again, I just left the template title here, but we also have this really wonderful resize area. So resize is an automatic feature in Canva that will take your design and to its best ability, resize it to fit any number of different preloaded in dimensions. So once I hover over one of these options, I can see it's considering a poster as 18 by 24. It's considering a presentation in the 16 by 9 ratio, so a standard screen being 1920 by 1080 pixels. Logos 500 by 500, so a square orientation that's probably similar to our Instagram post, 18 or 1080 by 1080 pixels. So you can pick any one of these or multiple to say this is what I would like this graphic changed in size to match or to accommodate. So let's also say we want to do a menu, sure, 8.5 by 11, and we want, I don't know, we might want this as a poster and, hey, a Facebook post so we can remind folks about the color codes for recycling in our building. This might be a silly example, but it's quick and easy. So we've selected all of the items we want to resize this document, and literally all we do is click copy and resize. So Canva does a bit of work here, and you can see at the very top of your screen now we have several new tabs open. So the first tab that's open here all the way to the right is saved as a copy, and now it's saying across the board all of these are copies so that we know what we're working with. So this, for example, is the Instagram post resize, and so you see it's made it nice and square. Like I said, it does it to its best ability, so there oftentimes are going to be elements that you are going to come in and need to move. But unlike having to completely redesign this every single time, all you have to do is make some adjustments in Canva because the rest of the resizing is done for you. So in this example, I might move these elements up to give us a little bit more space on the bottom. But now this Instagram post is really ready to go, which is very nice and easy. So if we're ready to export this, we can click share. We can share this across other people in this organization. We can share a link with someone else if we need someone to be able to review this before it's about to go out. Sharing a link to edit is really nice because you can share it amongst other CSU Extension users and logins. You can share a link to view, which is really nice for folks to be able to, let's say they're outside of the Extension organization, we don't want to give them the login information to Canva. We can let them view the marketing first to give us input. We can also click this handy download button that gives us the download menu and provides a variety of options for how to download. We would actually want to download this Instagram post as a JPEG because Instagram only allows us to post images. So here are two options there for Instagram. We also have PDF that we can save as, and video if you're doing an animation, if you're doing one of those animated graphics for your post, which I talked about in another video. We also have a variety of options here, including print posters. Print posters is not necessarily something that we'll be using in extension just because we have our brand approved vendors and printers across the state and throughout the country. But again, here's another download link. We can share the link. We can present. So Canva is a great tool for creating really beautiful presentations. We can share it to a Facebook page or Twitter, which we are not going to activate these simply because there are a variety of Facebooks and Twitters for extension, and we don't want to clutter up this interface with the wrong link. But all the other options for sharing and publishing our document are off to the side. If we go back up here to the top and look at some of the other sizes, let's look over here at the poster. So this is that 18-inch wide poster. This one resized really beautifully for us, so we really don't have to do anything to that. Again, with the Facebook post, it's recommending this orientation, which is the dimensions that fit into the Facebook window the best. So we'll want to select all of these. I'm just holding shift in between the clicks here so that it selects multiple objects, and then we can move all of them together. If we click the corner, we can resize them all together to fit this post a little bit better. So that's resizing and saving and exporting our Canva pieces. I hope this tutorial was helpful, and I hope you very much enjoy this new interface for extensions design and branding needs.